स्टूडेंट टुडे वी विल स्टडी ट्रिगोनोमेट्रिक इक्वेशंस। ओके ट्रिगोनोमेट्रिक इक्वेशन ट्रिगोनोमेट्रिक इक्वेशंस। ओके हियर यू विल गेट टू वर्ड्स प्रिंसिपल सॉल्यूशन। Principal solution. The next one is general solution. So you see, principal solution may be of two. Principal solution may be of two types. Two types meaning you will get two principal solution. Okay. Since you know there are four quadrants. Okay. Since there are four quadrants. Okay. So you can see sine, if I take suppose example I am taking sine, sine is negative in third and fourth quadrant. Okay, sine is negative in third and fourth quadrant. So sine is also positive in first and second quadrant. So you see in positive you are getting the first and second quadrant, and in the negative you are getting the third and fourth quadrant. So similarly with the other trigonometric functions, so you will get two principal solution, and you may get one or more than one general solution, means you can get two also. Okay, so see, for this you must know a theorem. Okay, you must know a theorem. So I am taking the theorem. Today we'll learn about the theorem. Okay, theorem. There are three theorems: sine, cos, and tan. Okay, how to find the general solution in sine, cos, and tan? So we are taking the first theorem. So see the first theorem. For any real numbers, for any real numbers x and y, okay, sin x equals sin y, sin x equals sin y implies x equal n pi plus minus 1 whole power n y, n belongs to z, means n is a integer. Okay, so we'll try to prove the theorem. See the proof. Given sin x equal sin y. Okay, it is given sin x equal sin y. With the help of sin x equal sin y, we must prove x equals to n pi plus minus 1 whole power n y, where n belongs to z. Okay, so see how I will prove it. Print this term to the left hand side. Sin x minus sin y equal to 0. Okay, now use the formula sin a minus sin b. What is sin a minus sin b? 2 cos a plus b divided by 2 sin a minus b divided by 2 equal 0. Okay, we are using sin a minus sin b. You can see the formula. Okay, now you see, with the help of this, what you will get? Next line, dividing both side by 2, what you will get? Here you will get 1. So it is remaining with cos x plus y by 2 sin x minus y by 2 equal 0. Okay, nice. A into b equal 0 means a equal 0 or b equal 0. You know this. Okay, multiplication of two terms equal 0 means either this is 0, the first term is 0, or the second term is 0, implies. Now previously we have learned in the graph, you can see there cos x equal 0, taking this whole term as x. Okay, so cos x equal 0, what it was, cos x equals 0 implies x equals to 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Okay, I'm taking this as x equal 2n plus 1 pi by 2, or sin x, this whole term take as x, sin x equals 0. What does x imply? X implies x equal n pi, n belongs to z. Okay, sin x equals 0, you can see the graph, in the graph I've shown you, sin x equals 0 implies x equal n pi. Here x is x minus y by 2, here x is x plus y by 2. What does cos x equals 0 implies? X equal 2n plus 1 pi by 2. So you can see here 2 will get cancelled because it is in the denominator. Okay, so what you will get, x plus y equal 2n plus 1 pi, and here you will get x minus y equal 2n pi. Okay, next see what does x imply. X equal 2n plus 1 pi minus y, or here x will imply 2n pi plus y, n belongs to j. Okay, now you see this is minus. Now you see how you will get m minus 2n plus 1 pi plus minus 1 whole power 2n plus 1 y, or x equal 2n pi plus minus 1 whole power n y, not n, twice n. Okay, n belongs to z. Okay, let's see. Here it is given minus. Now I have written in terms of minus 1. Okay, because I have to prove, no, x equal n pi plus minus 1 whole power n y. So I have to write in terms of minus 1. So how can this minus be written? Okay, so this minus can be written in terms of minus 1 whole power 2 n plus 1 y. Because you see, since 2n is a even number, okay, 2n is a even number, so adding 1 will always be a odd number, will always be a odd number. So power of any odd number will be negative, power of any odd number will be negative, because I have written in bracket minus 1. Okay, so minus 1 whole power odd number will be always a negative term. Minus 1 whole power odd number will always be a negative term. Okay, next you see in the second one, minus 1 whole power 2n is a even number. So minus 1 whole power even number will always be a positive sign. So this plus can be written as minus 1 whole power 2n, and this negative sign can be written as minus 1 whole power 2n plus 1. Okay, now you see combination, how can you combine these two? You see the coefficient of pi is 2n plus 1, and power is also 2n plus 1. When this is 2n plus 1, the power is 2n plus 1. When this is 2n, the power is 2n. Okay, so how can you combine these two? So combining these two results, comma, we get, we can write in terms of n pi plus minus 1 whole power n y, n belongs to z. It is a logical way. Okay, since this is 2n plus 1, this is 2n plus 1, the power is 2n plus 1. Since this is 2n, coefficient of pi is 2n, so the power is also 2n. Similarly, for n, it must satisfy. So the coefficient of pi is n, so the power must also be n, where n belongs to z. So combining these two, we will get this. Now you can see here, putting n equal 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, because n is an integer, so putting all the terms, all the numbers, you will get this and this. The first one and the second one. See, putting n equal 1, what you will get? 1 into pi plus minus 1 whole power n means minus, you will get in terms of minus 1 y. So what you are getting? Pi minus y. So you will get this one. Okay, pi minus y. Next, what you will get? You can see, putting n equal 2, what you will get? 2, I am showing this you for, you don't need to write this. Putting n equal to what you will get? 2 pi plus minus 1 whole power 2y. So since this is even number, minus 1 whole power even number will be positive. So 2 pi plus y. So n belongs to, this was n belongs to z. So no need to write n belongs to z. So you will get 2 pi plus y. So 2 pi plus y. Okay. So with this, we conclude for today. Next day we will learn principal solution and general solution. Okay, we'll do some problems related to principal solution and general solution.